recruitment, promotion and reward, I will strongly discourage, because I mean, it again comes from our philosophy. Our philosophy is 360 degree feedback is as subjective as people are. It is subjective. This is number one. It's not objective. Americans say it is objective, but I say it is not objective. It is subjective. It is subjectivity of about, let us say, 10, 15, 13, whatever it is, people collected at a given point of time. It is, it gives you feedback of the, not merely the impressions, but partly the expectations people have. You can't take expectations and disappointments as an indicator of your either performance or potential. It is only an indicative of the potential for development of an individual on those aspects. In fact, quite often, when I prepare people for 360 degree feedback, I tell them, partly in a lighter way, partly in a serious way, I tell them, if on a 5-point rating scale, somebody rates you as 5 out of 5, and somebody else rates you as a 3 out of 5, whom should you thank? I normally say, you thank the fellow who said 3 out of 5, not the fellow who rated. Because the fellow who rated you 5 out of 5 is saying, you are meeting all my expectations, you are wonderful, you are great, you can't do anything better anymore further. That means he's saying, this is your saturation point, I have no great expectation from you. Whereas a 3 fellow is saying, I hold you at a high esteem, today you are at this level, can you move up to this? So a good friend is the one who gives you a low rating. This is what I tell them. So when you get negative ratings, don't think, now if this is the interpretation we are giving, how can you take the rating as an indication? If any, I think a high rating should be taken as this fellow has mesmerized everyone. So for recruitment, promotions, etc., it is not 360. But what I recommend is, after 360, if the fellow has mutually agreed targets, he goes through this, you can ask him an action plan. 1 through 360, we have spent some money on you. Tell us, what have you learned? What do you want to do? Suppose he says, I have learned nothing. There is nothing new in it. I'm not going to do anything different. Fine. Forget about it. Somebody says, this is what I want to do different. You can evaluate. You agree with it. Make it a part of your KRA. Evaluate. It's not the 360. It is the actions that the individual has undertaken after this, where he communicated. So if you want to use that, you can use it maybe to recognize and so on. But personally, we are against using this for promotions and for recruitment and reward. Output of it, which is shown in terms of behavior change, this we are strict about it. If you follow Center for Creative Leadership, North Carolina, they also come up with the same thing. If you don't ever ask, in fact, in our MOU, we get a company to sign that we will not ask for the data. I think I will tell these 41% of those who say yes, the firm which collects three space for the 360 data, should they collect the data on each individual? You will be doing the best possible damage to these individuals by collecting the data. The moment you know the individual data are going to be supplied to the company, and the then individuals have a knack of putting up behaviors mainly during the 360 period of time, or by and large showing behaviors which in order to get popularity. We are not like politicians in for this kind of, we are serious people, professional people and so on. So I don't recommend, but there is a trick in the question you have asked, Vijay. Should the firm that pays for 360, why should the firm pay for your 360? If you are interested, don't get into it. But if the firm pays for your 360 and the firm wants, then do all the manipulation that is possible.
Yeah, and this is what is happening, sir. I run like 4 to 6 360 degree assignments a year. And every time my client says that, okay, share me individual level data, I always refuse. It's a class, you know, it's a non-negotiable term that I will share with you what was said. I will never share with you who said it. Because it's not only your credibility, it's the credibility of
who
the
firm. Who said, also. You're also not likely to know. But there are ways in which people are smart. Yeah. They try to, like, I can tell you many stories of how people try to find out.
Yeah.
I appreciate your point, because in LinkedIn, I'll read out, I'm sure you all noted this.
Yes.
One of the persons made a comment saying something very interesting. experience industries, consultants for media, entertainment, satellite TV, cable TV, cinema, online gaming, etc., etc. All of them have said that 360 degree feedback has created a lot of issues and created groupism, created a lot of other problems. It has gone out of fashion. Why are we talking about it? Okay. So that kind of a negative kind of a comment comes from these kind of experiences, because in the hands of, I mean, you have a knife which can be used for very positive purposes. You can also use it to cut your own head, cut the head of others and things like that. It depends on the way the instrument is. So you are very right. And unfortunately, across the world today, everything has become commercialized. Even, I mean, when we use 360, it's not that we do it for free. We also have to make sure that we get compensated for it and so on. But there is a limit to which you can do the commercialization part. Yeah. That's where you got into it. Understandable. Many HR managers say, I want to do 360 so that I can have it on my biodata. And my company says, so what is the point of doing it without giving this? So I think people do all kinds of things. I'm not into this. I don't agree with that, and I don't suppose that's the right thing.